Alright. This episode of Justin Yumi is presented in THX, where available. Yeah. Best sound, the best picture, you're watching a THX certified episode. In association with Nickelodeon. In association with Nickelodeon.
Nickelodeon! Nickelodeon!
Yeah, Nickelodeon!
Nickelodeon!
All right. Again, no theme song. We still have to make one, but yeah. Hello, everybody. Cheer upon Molly here, and your favorite guest room here. And it's me, Justin. And also, and we also have with us the producer and direct and the boss herself. Yep, it's me, Unikitty, and I'm her boss, Shine.
Yeah. Oh. Well, all right. Well, hey, howdy. Hey, everybody. Yumi.
Yeah. Yes, everybody. It's me, Yumi. I'm a Yumi. As long as that show runs, I'm going to work because I'm sweet and very fast.
Yep. And welcome back to another episode of These Two, or us watching Go Diego Go. Yes, we're back for another episode of Go Diego Go. You want to see another one? Well, you're officially in luck. Yes, Shine. And tonight's episode we're watching is something that has to do with today's Nickelodeon logo. The Mommy Macaw.
Mommy Macaw. I can't wait to watch this.
Yes. So yeah, this episode has to deal with parrots. Rock! This episode has to deal with parrots. Yeah. Okay, Molly. Now you're giving me upside down show vibes. Yeah.
Ah, Mario, you're giving me upside down show vibes.
Yeah. You know, speaking of the upside down show, hey Boo. If we have time later on tonight, do you actually want to watch an episode of the upside down show? You know, Mario, now that you mention it, yeah, it actually has been a long time since we haven't watched the upside down show.
Yes, I want more CD yet.
Yes, we got a lot of stuff to bring back on this channel ever since our old channel, but it's a long story. But yeah, but anyways, let's go ahead and watch Go Diego Go, the Mommy Macaw. Put this full screen. So yeah, good idea for you so Boo, that's actually a good idea that we're gonna watch the Upside Down show again. I know, Shine, because like we said, it's been a long time since we haven't watched that show. Yeah, and this episode right here has to deal with a parrot, so hopefully it's not the same parrot from the Upside Down show. Spoiler alert, it's not.
Yeah. Yeah, spoiler alert, the butter is spoiled.
This. All right, here we go. Another episode of Nick Jr.'s Go Diego Go. Hi, Diego. Yep. Huh. Oh, it's right there. Also, I find it interesting how someone recorded this off Noggin.
Oh, yeah. I actually know.
Yeah, well, that's using your Noggin.
Yeah, that big forehead of a Noggin. All right.
Lucia. She's out exploring in the rainforest.
Really?
Diego, look what I found in the rainforest. A scarlet macaw's nest.
Huh?
With a little scarlet macaw and a baby egg, but no mommy macaw.
There's no... Oh, Jesus, Will. So there's no mommy macaw. So wait, is this macaw an orphan?
Dun, dun, dun!
Oh, jeez. Oh, this poor thing. Without a mommy, we're going to have to take this into foster home. But not just any foster home. A foster home for imaginary friends.
Or... Maybe the orphanage from Three Stooges. Oh, wait, that's for humans.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. But. We'll get someone else to take care of it. Wait, Yuki, what about you?
Well.
Perhaps we should get help for another Saturday here.
Yeah, right. But you take care of it. I barely even know how to take care of a kid. And, come on, our pressure isn't that hard.
Maybe get Cass to take care of it.
True. That's a good point because I remember Cass had to babysit the mini pups in that one High Puff Yami Yumi episode. Oh yeah, I remember that. I think it was mini pups. That's what it was called.
Yeah. Oh yeah, don't get me started on mini pups. They almost tried to take the band name away from us.
Exactly. But I mean, at least if Cass would take. If Kaz can take care of a Scarlet Macaw, then I think it'll be better for him to take care of John King of Tech Guy, because you know Kaz doesn't do well with John King of Tech Guy.
Mm. Oh, well, at least I will actually do a better job being a better, or maybe where it is.
Yeah, true. All right, moving on.
Diego, you have to find the mommy macaw and bring her back to the nest. Quick! Don't worry, Alicia. I'll find her.
Yeah, wait. Yeah, why don't you finally go? I gotta go away. I already found the macaw. Time to pull up my wrist of your cheetah. Stupid. There it is. Okay. I know I'm more toy, but I don't want to do it. Buzz Lightyear to start to man. Locate a monument on the hazard we did it for a paper car. Oh, because there seems to be no sign of intelligent life anywhere.
Yeah, there's no macaws anywhere, so we're gonna have to find that mommy in the car. Well, we better get going.
Alright, let me just pull up my wrist of you, Chase. Buzz. Yeah. We don't need that. We have a camera. How's that camera gonna? Okay, Buzz, just trust us, okay? Just let us do its job.
Buzz. This ain't no ordinary camera. This is a special talking camera.
Oh right, I totally forgot that we're in a kitchen and everything talks.
Yes. So we're gonna have to talk to Click the camera.
Yeah. Okay. I know what to say. I'm gonna say Adam Sandler movie.
Yep.
Hey, Adam Sandler movie.
Click.
Adam Sandler movie.
Take a pick.
What the frick?
That rhymes.
I just picked up my stick. Here we go. Here we go. Say, hey, Click! Shut the frick! I'm sorry, I wanted to do it. Okay.
Paul,
It's okay. All right.
Let's zoom through the forest and listen for the
scarlet. Let's go, licorice speed.
Yes. All right. Here we go.
The whistle like the scarlet macaw.
No.
No. Wait. Is that the Fire Nemo seagull?
Let's see.
No, that's a harpy eagle.
A harpy eagle?
Oh no, not the eagles, no.
Now, all right, next.
Hey, Woody Woodpecker!
No, that's Woody Woodpecker.
It's Woody Woodpecker.
No, click.
Hey, go back to your bird's house.
All right, next.
Does this sound like the scarlet macaw?
No, that's Rocky and Ginger.
Yeah, watch out, Mr. Twig is gonna take your ass.
Yes. Next.
Party! Oh wait, it's macaw. Wait.
Yes, that's the scarlet macaw.
Oh, it's party! It's party!
Take a picture of the mommy scarlet macaw.
Say. He better show my mommy. Oh, another mommy.
The Scarlet Macaw.
We about party.
The Scarlet Macaw? That's the mommy Scarlet Macaw.
So it's confirmed. Potty is a mother.
Yes.
She looks like she's in trouble.
Wait.
Come on, really, Super Bunny? You're almost gonna lounge on furniture.
I'm sorry. Whenever I hear someone say a troll, I will always be there.
Yeah, that's true, Super Bunny. Whenever there's an animal in trouble or something, you'll always be there. Well, we already found the skull of Macaw, and now we have to find out why she's in trouble.
Yes, I must find the location. We must find the location of the Macaw.
Yeah, you forgot right. We're doing it. Tell you, aliens!
Oh, right.
Well, we're all working together.
Oh, right. We're a team.
Yeah, right.
Come on, Super Bunny. You can't do this alone.
Right. Super Heroes need sidekicks.
Yes. Okay.
To see more of the picture, click me to zoom out.
Oh, right. Come on.
Zoom.
I don't know where the location of the Macaw is.
I knew that. Oh, look! Mommy Macaw's wing is stuck between two rocks. That's why she's not with her babies.
Hold on, Mommy Macaw! We're gonna come and rescue you!
Yes! And it's also superheroes that do the job! Or animal rescuers. Whatever!
Let's go!
Oh, away!
Squawk, squawk!
Squawking!
Squawk, squawk!
Squig! Squawk! Super Bunny is squawk, not squeak! When you saw the book, not a mouse. Oh, right. I jumped my mouse. I got my ammo sounds mixed up.
Yeah, we're looking for this. We're looking for a skull in the car. Huh. Incoming! What the? What? Ow!
Oh my god. Citizen, are you okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm okay. I heard the sound of a Scarlet Macaw, and I'm gonna help too because I heard it stuck between a rock her wing is stuck between like a rock or something and needs to get home to her baby. Yeah. Wait. Yeah. Hold on. Smolder? Yeah, guys. It's been a while since you haven't saw me. Smolder.
Smolder? Why aren't you in the boulder?
I get it. That rhymes. Yeah. Smolder?
Wait. Hold on. Starla McCall is talking about what that means. Dwight Johnson has the McCall!
Okay. Yeah, so Smolder?
Are you trying to see that Maui has the McCall? I mean, he already has a chicken. He's going to take it to the boat to get the piece of resistance back. So why does that mean he has a McCall? He already had a chicken.
Okay. Anyways, Smolder, what are you doing in the jungle? Like I said, Jason, I heard the mommy macaw too. I heard it's not with her babies and with her kid, and its wing is stuck between like a rock or something. Yeah, Smolder.
Yeah, Smolder. Dwight Johnson has the rock. Maui has the macaw, and he's doing it here for lunch.
Dwayne Johnson has the. Really? Dwayne? Dwayne Johnson with a mommy macaw.
Yes, because look. The camera said that you start doing rocks, and we all know the rock is the name is Dwayne Johnson. So if you start in the rocks, and one name is Dwayne Johnson, that means Dwayne Johnson has the macaw.
Is this true, Jason? don't listen to Woody Smolder. He's just messing with you. I mean that is true. Like the rock is his nickname, but plus the rock never appeared on Go Diego Go.
I know, but yeah. Wait. Woody, I just realized something. What? Dwayne Johnson's also a wrestler. What that means? Oh no, he's gonna switch with always wrestling!
Yeah, Dwayne Johnson is a wrestler too, besides an actor.
Oh my god. Well, in the words of Woody in one episode of Daphne, oh, Woody, you're so stupid today.
Yeah. So, Smolder, are you going to help us find the Scarlet Macaw? Yes. Oh, that reminds me. Let me go get my special weapon.
Special weapon? What are you talking about,
Boo? Oh. Let's see, Smolder.
Good boy, Woody's thinking it's like Dwayne Johnson, the one. I know for a fact that Dwayne Johnson never appeared in Go Diego Go. That's what Bill said.
Yeah. Okay, Smolder, this is my special weapon. What? A fork? Really? Not just any fork, Smolder. It's my pitchfork. And why do you have your pitchfork when it's literally a fork? Don't judge it, Smolder. Now listen, the reason why I have this is because I'm gonna get some payback after what happened in the last Go Diego Go episode. I'm looking for two monkeys. Two monkeys?
Yes. What? Donkey Kong? Diddy Kong?
No, not Donkey Kong. Come on.
Mojo Jojo.
Alright, Boo. Who exactly are you looking for? The Bobo Brothers. The Bobo Brothers?
Oh, well, yes, you two little monkeys, they're two little shits.
Somebody,
language.
Language, the kid show.
They're just two little shitheads that are just doing, they're just fucked up the entire jungle.
Oh my god. Yeah, you're gonna have to pour in Super Bunny Smolder, but yeah, well, I'm looking for the Bobo Brothers. And whenever that moment comes, that's when I'm gonna use this pitchfork. And plus, Woody can still help out too. Why? Because a few episodes ago when we watched Chinta the Baby Chinchilla, Woody used a special weapon called a freeze ray. A freeze ray?
Yes. Well, let me explain. See, in the show, they started by saying freeze Bobos, which is basically, and what is the type of object they use for freeze? Ice! So, this ice ray from Gru to actually freeze the Bobos, literally.
Yeah. Yeah, so Smolder, when we see the Boba Buddies later on, you'll see what we're gonna do with these. Okay? Okay. Yeah,
you get those two little monkey shits.
Yeah.
Oh god, Super Body.
Yeah, you better be careful. We're not getting this video age restricted today. Okay. Moving on. Well, in the words of the tour guide from Madagascar 2 Escapes Africa. Moving on.
Yes. Here we go.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, wow. Well, in the words of Bart Simpson from the Plush Toy Storytime of Reggie Secret Admirer, wow, that's a lot of James Bonds for my version. Wow, that's a lot of macaws. Clearing, boo. If you mention macaw one more time, I'm going to trap you in a drawer for 2 weeks.
Or drawbridge. I think you mean drawbridge.
Jesus Christ almighty. Yeah, Joel. I'm kidding, Boo. I only want to do that Mike's Toontown thing. Oh, of course.
Yeah. What, you want to move the bridge? How about going to drawbridge? Because I'm a grumpy old troll who was under the bridge.
Hey. Yeah. Okay, so... Wow, that's a lot of macaws. But, how do we know which one we're looking for? We're looking for a certain macaw smolder. It's red. It has red, blue, and yellow colors on it. So it's a mix of red, blue, and yellow? Yes.
Yeah. If you push the yellow with white, it's a Texas macaw. Yeehaw!
Okay.
Here's the picture of the scarlet macaw. Scarlet macaw has a red tummy. Let's look for the scarlet macaw.
Okay.
Is this a scarlet macaw?
No. No, no, that's blue from Rio.
Yeah, blue, Rio. Well, in the words of Swamper Buddy, what are you doing here?
Yes, you need to be back home in Rio. Oh, I mean, this does take place in the jungle, and Rio 2 also takes place in the jungle, but still.
Yeah, what are you doing here, Chubby? You're supposed to be in Rio. You're doing it in a
little
pet show.
Yeah, you're a bananas, B. You got the wrong show.
No, this macaw is blue. We're looking for a macaw with a red tummy.
Hi.
Is this a scarlet macaw?
No.
Wait. Hey, it's a Jacksepticeye macaw.
Jacksepticeye macaw.
Yeah. I think we found the perfect pet macaw for Malps.
Malps, if you're watching this score macaw is for you because you love Jacksepticeye and it's green too.
Yeah, green like Jacksepticeye.
Okay.
No, this macaw is green. We're looking for a macaw with a red.
Yeah, it's a clean macaw.
That's it. That's it.
It has a red tummy.
So how are we gonna get that in? I say I'll use my super strength and break that rug into pieces and we touch her.
Don't worry, Mommy McCall. We'll rescue you. We need something that will help us climb up to the mommy scarlet macaw.
Don't need to climb up, fly up, there ain't nothing for you.
Well, okay. Abiba day.
Abiba
day. Abiba day. Okay. This time, when Rescue Pack transforms into something, I hope he doesn't transform into the bicycle again, just like the previous episodes.
Yes, we already don't need something. We don't need Pee Wee's special bike. Don't know what I said. Oh.
Yes, we need something else this time. Okay, let's see how it goes.
Yeah, I.
Okay, hopefully. All right. Okay. Okay, I'm going to pretend the first thing he does is a bike.
A boat?
Oh, boat? Okay, never mind.
A rope?
Or a pair of ice skates.
The rope.
A rope. Right. Now you tell Diego he needs a rope.
Got it.
Yeah. Go use a rope, and then all that, you're all praying for a poop.
Yes. Okay. Good. We didn't get the bicycle this time. Okay.
Climb with me.
All right. Climb.
Oh, what was that?
I was looking for food for my family, but
you know, it'll be a lot more easier if we can fly.
Yeah, true. But I mean, Diego doesn't have wings or anything, so we have to do the easy way. And, oh well. Hold still.
Oh, Mommy McCaw, looks like you need a bandage.
Oh yeah, that's gotta hurt. Oh, Mommy McCaw, you're lucky that wasn't me who doesn't have a broken wing like that.
Yeah, cause in the words of you're in the movie's director,
wee, that's gonna hurt.
Yeah. Don't worry, Mommy McCaw. I'll find a band-aid for you. That was easy.
In the meantime, I will keep an eye on this McCaw and make sure no baddies go on. Wait, and just please be a metric army to you. Why me, Trump? Well, for what I heard, you were working for this Counselor Chang person, and you were good when Jake found you, and then you just... the neighbor. Oh, it's not my fault, mate, okay? Hey, you got a problem with me, bro? You got a problem with me? Me. You're the villain here. Yeah. Well, don't judge me, that I actually, that chick doesn't work for Peanuts. Peanuts? With Charlie Brown? No. Why would I want for Charlie Brown? Well, I have no idea.
Okay, guys. I'm back. And I found the band-aid for Mommy McCaw.
Oh, brilliant! And hold on, you. What, you see something? Yeah, what? So you look a baddest kid, yo.
Yeah, Banansby, I mean, it's shaped like a rectangle, like a bandage. Hold on, look.
I'm shaped like a square. Look, it's a rectangle, and I'm a square. Well, I'm not in any shape. I'm just a regular custom shape.
Yeah, look, Banansby, I found a bandage for the Mommy McCaw.
Go get your lot in here, please.
All right. I'll show you the bandage about what I found.
It's like, since when did a bandage that you found it has very much been like a little girl?
A little girl? Correction. Little boy. What? Rudy?
I'm so sorry for assuming your gender. I thought you... Okay, I thought that was Penny for a second.
No, I'm not Penny. Penny is somewhere else right now.
Well, yeah, it's not my fault. out okay. That I almost accused. Wait, no, not accused you. Yo. I almost assumed it because of the shadow. Well, you're talking to me. No. Oh my God, yo.
I'm supposed to call bananas, B. Rudy. It's okay. But Splinter, why did you think I was a mandate? Oh, well, helping the mommy. We're helping this mommy McCaw right here. By the way, watching Go Diego go. Look what happened to her wing. Oh, jeez, that looks terrible. I feel so bad for her. I could draw a bandage for her. Rudy, we'd love for you to do that, but Diego's got it covered. What, Diego? Yeah, he brought a box of bandages for her. Oh, okay. Looks like that was my talk.
Yeah, because of the words I said. For now on, I'm calling you Diego.
Oh, yeah, Diego. Yep, same name. Well, so, can I see proof that Diego took care of this? Sure, Rudy. And by the way, do you want to help us take the macaw home? Sure, I mean, oh, man, I actually do feel bad for her. Yeah, we do, Rudy. Anyways.
All right, everybody, keep all alert. Alert, we got him.
Okay.
It's the rainbow colored bandage. The first one, the second one, or the third one?
Okay, the second one.
Yeah, because that really looks like a man. Yo,
okay. Yep, that's the right one, yo.
But the rainbow colored bandage, mommy McCaw's wing.
Here you go.
Feels better, but I can't fly yet.
Oh, you can't fly. Well, now you know how Blue feels in the first movie of Rio because he couldn't fly.
Yeah, and me too.
Yeah, Buzz, because you can't fly because you're a toy and you tried to prove it in the first Toy Story movie but failed.
Yeah, which I keep on telling him multiple times. I even said like in his like mind when he was looking up to the window. I said, "You are a toy, you can't fly."
Yeah. Yeah. And also, Mommy McCaw, little advice. Don't start flying yet. Because if you start to fly, then your wing is probably going to hurt still. And it's going to get even worse. Take, for example, with Wubsy. In the Wild Wubsy episode, The Tired Tail, Wubsy had some events he wants to go to. But the doctor told him to stay home. So his tail can recover. But he didn't listen to him, and he just went to the events, and his tail got even worse.
Yes, because he seemed to listen to Dr. Fluey. Now he has the rest of his tail even longer.
Exactly, Walden. Now, we just hope the Mommy McCaw doesn't do the same exact thing. Don't fly, otherwise the wing's going to get even worse. Yeah, because,
Yes. Listen to Dr. Smulders' orders.
Yes, doctor's orders.
And I need to fly up to the tallest tree to be with my babies. It's okay, Mommy McCaw. We'll help you get back to the tallest tree.
Yeah.
Yes, Diego. Let's go, amigos. We need to bring Mommy McCaw to the tallest tree so she can be with her babies.
Okay. Okay.
Searching for the tallest tree, Spider McCaw and you and me. Let's all squawk the way they do. Come on, you do it too. Come on, squawk.
Squawk! Squawk, squawk! Squawk!
Squawk, squawk!
Squawk, squawk! 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 Squawk!
For the tallest tree, Spider McCaw and you and me. Let's all squawk the way they do. Come on, you do it too.
Okay. Flap, 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 flap.
Wait a minute, I just realized. We're paper. Paper flap, arrows flap. Can flap. Like what? If I actually run sideways, it looks like I'm flapping wings.
Yeah. Climb. 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 Huh. Yep. Okay.
There are so many trees in the rainforest.
Yeah, hang on a minute. Well, Diego, what do we expect? It's the rainforest. But there's actually a tallest tree in the rainforest. Yeah, Rudy. We're looking for the tallest tree. It's like even taller than King Julian's tree from Madagascar in the first movie where his plane was at before they used it in the second movie.
Yeah. How long is this gonna take?
We need to find the tallest tree, Diego. We can use my spotting scope to help us find the tallest tree. Make a spotting scope with your hands to look for the tallest tree in the rainforest.
Okay.
Do you see the tallest tree in the forest?
Hmm. Oh, yeah. That's a tall tree.
Wow, I don't even know what trees can fall this tall.
Yeah. Like, that tree, someone must have fed that tree one of my super mushrooms, and now it's really tall.
Yeah.
Okay. Huh?
That's my video watch. Alicia's calling from the Scarlet Macaw tree.
Let's see.
Look, I made a blanket out of leaves to keep the baby at warm.
Great thinking, Alicia. Thanks for taking care of my babies.
You're welcome, Mommy Macaw. But Diego, the little macaw is very hungry, and we have no food in the nest.
No food?
We need to get some food for my babies, Diego. Don't worry, Mommy
Macaw. No food. Well, in the words of SML Woody from the Jeremysville meme SML Woody, no food, no water, no jail, no campfires.
Well, let's go find some food. Food. Yeah.
Yep.
Well, yeah, and you know what? I'll go find some food. And I'll try not to make the same mistake like with Sandbar from 4 years ago.
Yeah. Well, only one way to go. To the supermarket! Oh wait, we're in the rainbow. There are no stores here.
Crap! Yeah, Smolder, I'll go find some food. What, are you sure, Shine? Yeah, because like you said, I don't want you to like freak out like Smolder from Sandball from 4 years ago. That's true. Okay.
Well, in the words of Markiplier at Santa Claus, don't screw it up, kids! Ed's what my version. Don't screw it up, Shine.
All right.
Oh my god, okay. What? Oh, Superboy, are you still suspicious with bananas B? Yes! Look. Like, Superboy, that was the whole thing with Blesby would change. That was years ago. This is the now. Oh. Yeah, yo. Well, look. Besides, I haven't seen Chan in a long time, okay? Okay, look. He's not here. It's only me. No. Look. I used to be evil, but I'm not, okay? I changed. Well, in the words, I think it's your rotten tooth in Vermont, Brother Bear. I can change. I can change. Oh, liar, it has to be. I can change you! Okay, I believe you.
Oh my god. Please
tell me
there's some food.
Okay.
Perfect. Okay. Okay, guys. I'm back. And I actually found this box of Dunkin' Donuts Munchkins in the middle of the rainforest.
What? Who leaves donuts in the forest?
Someone's been littering. Someone's disrespecting the nature by littering. But, I mean, this is food.
Maybe
all right.
Wasn't left those here.
Mm-mm. Yeah, I have no idea who left them here. I know it wasn't me, but... Oh, well. Anyways, I better see how many donuts there are. What the heck? What is it, Shine? Justin, look what's in here. What the... Oh, my God. What? No way.
What is it?
There's no food in here. But I think it's actually the next best thing I've ever seen.
There's the D. A Mike's Ruby DVD!
Yeah. Well,
bananas!
It is money.
Money? Money? Oh, we're rich! We're rich!
Wow. I never expected. Shine, you actually found some money for us. Huh. Okay, I guess there's no food in here, but I found some money though. But Shine, there's something I want to tell you. Shine, I know you're happy that we got some money right here, but that's not what we're looking for. We need to find some food, because what about the baby macaw? What's more important, money or a baby macaw? Whoa. Because the words of Woody from when we watched the Blues Clues episode, Meet Blues Baby Brother, because family is more important than money. Oh. You know what, Mario? You're right.
Yeah. Perhaps we can use the money to buy for the macaw. What? There are no supermarkets in the jungle, remember? Oh, crap, you're right.
Yeah. Well, in the meantime...
buy them the survival way.
Yeah. Well, I'll hold on to this for later. For now... Wait, there's something else? There's something else in the box. I found... Hold on a minute. There was something else in the box. I found this.
A friendship princess?
Friendship princess? Ugh. Hey, guys. What? Twilight Sparkle? What are you doing inside that munchkin box? Well, I heard you guys were finding some food. I almost forgot to get out of the box, too, because I heard... The reason why I was hiding in that box is because... I've heard some evil giggles going on. Evil giggles? Who were they from? Don't tell me who I think it was. Who were they from? I heard it's from some angry teacher named Mr. Bohoffner. Mr. Bohoffner. One of Jackson's guys.
Are you talking about that thing Bob under that beer in the Q&A? They streamed in yesterday?
Yeah, that's what I was talking about. Yeah, because Mr. Bohoffner was hunting for a pony like me, and I had to go hiding, so I hid inside that munchkin box, and Mr. Bohoffner was nearby, but he went away, so I'm safe for now.
Oh, yeah, last time I joined the stream, he was picking on me.
That jerk, dang, like, now I see why Jack the Man Guy really hates Mr. Bohoffner. Yeah, he's rude towards not just people, but animals too, like me. Dang. I feel so sorry for you, Twilight. Yeah, me too, Twilight. Oh, hey, Smolder, I didn't know you were here. Yeah, I'm here in the jungle too. We're helping the Mommy Macaw here. Mommy Macaw? Yeah, Twilight. Also, it's been a while since I saw you, but we're helping this Mommy Macaw get home to her kid in the tallest tree. And do you want help, too? Because we need to find some food as well. We have to go forage for some food here in the rainforest.
Yeah, we're going to need all the help we can get. Yo. I mean, as a monkey, that also... was I from the jungle? No, wait. Well, my son wasn't from a jungle. I was from some gay. Crap. I forgot what it was called. Where I came from. I was a temporary. I was a temporary magical guardian. Where did I come from again? I mean, well, not to show. I know I'm from Air Tactic 1. Well, I'm season 2, aka the season that. That doesn't seem like this much. I mean, I'm talking about, like, the place where I came from.
You don't want to answer me. That's a really good question.
Yeah, because I remember I came out from a box because they because some lady was all like the blah 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 blah, blah, blah Jade long ink long comma J blah 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 something and something that old lady is talking nonsense. I don't know what she said. Ah, my language is incorporating with me. No.
It's okay, Mansby. Some of us have trouble speaking these days.
Yeah. I just want, also, like, I don't know if this is true or not, but apparently the... Wait, hold on. There's a thing that if a person is actually in trouble speaking words, it shows something that he's autistic.
Oh.
That having problem speaking words a ink thing. All right, let me just find out. So, I'm in the future using speaker. I mean, at least it's what I think it is. I don't know. Maybe it's because you're just stuttering words. Oh, I don't know. This is making up stuff in my mind. Or maybe you're just questioning stuff in your mind, yo.
Yeah. Anyways, Friday, do you want to help us forage for some food and bring them back to Mommy Claw's tallest tree?
Yeah, true. I'll help.
Okay, good. We're going to need all the help we can get.
We're going to get some money. I mean, food for the wicker. Oh, time to toss you all the money. Come on. We're heroes, not Mr. Krabs.
All right.
Great,
Diego. See you soon.
Yes, Mr. Lee. At least CB.
Nuts,
seeds, and figs. Oh, my word.
Bananas? Wait, you like bananas?
Wait, hold on. Hold on, let me get the street.
Yo. Did you say you love bananas? That's what I remember too! Because I'm a monkey!
So, I did not even know that parrots like bananas.
I didn't know we were going to see bananas. Yeah, wait. Oh! Someone say bananas? Yes, Boots! They say the B word, the bananas! Oh, yeah. Oh, I didn't know a bird actually eats bananas. I know! Yo!
Something interesting. Yeah. So it appears that Mommy McCall wants bananas, and she said yes.
Well, yo, I guess McCall is making it my language. I mean, our language says we're about monkeys, we're about bananas, you know, banana and monkeys do go together. But then,
yeah. Okay. Oh, there's the bananas, and you know, Diego, before we go get the bananas, they should have at least played a song over it.
A song? What song, Twilight?
You'll see. Hold on a minute. I'll go ahead and play the song real quick. Hopefully we won't get copyrighted from it. But I'm talking about this song. From Sesame Street.
I am sure that you're a banana. If you're gonna peel and eat them, why not take the time to eat them? When they're yellow, they're delicious. Too hard and brown, too squishy. Eat and play the slice of measure. Cook them up for a nice special. Banana. Yeah, we love
it, banana. Banana. Whoa, yo, this puppy perfect because I got.
Oh,
Got yourself some banana muffins.
Well, this is banana, B. Only boy to pull out, you.
Yes, there's some bananas right there, Diego.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Come to Papa. Come to bananas, B. Give it to me. Give me the black.
Okay. Oh! Yes! Finally!
Oh, no! Not those two little monkey shits! Now, I'm not talking about you Bananas B and Boots. God, yeah, thank God.
So, is that the Boba Brothers? Yes, Boba. Perfect timing. Because those silly monkeys were probably going to get that bananas, too. Not on my watch.
Yeah.
Woody, do you have the freeze ray?
Yes, I actually do. Yeah, good. Get off those banana tree or you're fired!
Now, let's look for those. You have Mrs. Spacely. Now let's look for those Mobile Brothers. Ooh, yum, yum, yum. There they are! Oh no, you don't!
You're stealing our bananas! Get back here! Yes, but I belong to us! What are you doing?
Yes. Freeze, Bobos! Gotcha.
Yes. That was showing that ain't got bananas, yo. Yeah, yo. You mess with the wrong jungle neighborhood, yo. You know what I'm taking them as far.
Finally got them, because in the last episode, they got away after making an avalanche. Well, don't need this anymore. Yeah! Ow! Oh! Uh-oh. Boo, did you just throw this pitchfork at me? Oh, dear. Wait, Helen? Yeah, someone do this. Well, in the words of Baker Smurf from the Smurf School, who shrunk the banana Smurf at the birthday cake with my version? Who threw this pitchfork right almost at my eye? Not me. I don't know. Boo?
What? It was Boo. He
didn't. Well, do you realize you could have almost poked me in the eye with this thing? I'm sorry, Helen. I was done using this after we caught the Bobo Brothers. Well, you're lucky this almost didn't hit me in the eye. Sorry, Helen. It's okay. Look, if you're gonna hand it over to me, you could have at least you gotta put the handle down. Because remember what happened with Chef Pee-Pee? Oh, that's right, because in the SML movie, in that one SML movie, Toad poked Chef Pee-Pee in the eye with a knife.
Oh, yes, yeah, I actually remember. But it was trying to taste banana muffins.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and play the again.
Oh, no, I'm so good.
Yes. Here's the clip.
Come on. Yeah, this smells good. Should be. What the f*** is wrong with you? You bought me in my eye. Oh, you son of a s***. You f***ing mushroom. What the f*** is wrong with you? There you go, Shabby.
Yeah, Boo. You're lucky you didn't poke me. You're lucky that didn't get me in my eye. Yeah. Well, in the words of Bonnie from The Simpsons, you got lucky.
Yeah, you got lucky, yo.
Huh, yeah. Anyways, Jesse, guys, what are you doing? Oh, you see, Helen, we're getting some bananas. Bananas? Yeah, we're helping Mommy McCarthy bring some bananas home to her family up in the tallest tree. Oh, I see. Also, Helen, I don't think we've ever introduced you to this character, but I want you to meet the boss of the series, and also Unicade's boss. Who is it? Oh, hi. Wait, aren't you Shine, the lead singer of the Web Girls? Yep, that's me. I'm Unicade's boss of the student auditions of Justin and Yumi. And who are you? I think I've never seen you before. Oh, I'm Helen. I'm Martha's owner from Martha Speaks. Oh, yeah. I think Sparkle told me about that show. Did you feed your dog Alphabet Soup and she got the ability to talk? Yep. I actually didn't know that Alphabet Soup gave her the ability to talk. It was supposed to go to her stomach, but it went to her brain.
Oh. Well, okay. Well, but you're actually joining those banana phones, aren't you? I am. You know what? Why don't you have this last one, Boots?
Wait, I can have this last one?
What? Well, yeah, look, you're a monkey just like me. I want to share with you. Brothers that don't share. What did I tell you? The bulbars are two little mice. Oh, shit. Okay, yeah. You need to work on that language. I know. I just. Okay, at least you two are sharing the bananas, but bulbars, they're being selfish.
Okay. Yes. So, yeah, Helen, do you want to help us bring the mom and the car home? Sure, Justin. Okay, good. Let's go ahead and get those bananas. And, yeah. Hey, one question. What is it, Helen? I wonder if one of these bananas is a phone. What are you talking about, Helen? There's no such thing as a banana phone. Yes, there is. From that one song. What? Oh, I know what you're talking about, Helen. Yep, I'll show you if I could just play the song real quick. Okay, I'm gonna stop right there because I don't want to get copyrighted, but yeah. Very funny, Helen. Okay. Anyways, no more time wasting. Let's go ahead and bring these bananas back home to the tallest tree.
Here, Mom and Nicole. You must be hungry too. Gracias, Diego. Come on, Mom and Nicole.
Yes. Here we go again. Squawk! 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 Flap, 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 flap. Flap, 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 flap. Climb, 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 climb. Climb, 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 climb. Wait.
Look, a picture of a karate.
A karate? Huh. I think I've ever heard of these animals before.
Yeah, what animal species hybrid is this?
Hold on a minute. Karate. I'll look them up later, Shine. Okay.
Karates live in this part of the forest. Macaws are afraid of karates. Do you see the karates?
Oh yeah. There's one right there. There it is, right there.
There it is. And there's Alicia with the
yes, really holds in there. And already feeling my rocking bones.
Yes. Alicia! Yes. Alicia!
What's your over?
Alicia!
Fly up to her babies.
Yes, we will.
Great. Flap your wings with Mommy Macaw.
Okay. Flap. 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 The miracle of birth. This is it.
Look, aww. She doesn't have feathers yet. I have a new baby sister. Here, Mommy Macaw. Gracias, Diego.
Ate some bananas.
Yum, yum. Thanks for keeping my baby safe, Alicia. You're welcome, Mommy Macaw. And thanks for rescuing me, Diego. De nada. We are monsters.
Bananas, banana.
Scarlet Macaw. Come on, say it with me.
Scarlet Macaw. Scarlet Macaw. Scarlet Macaw.
Well, I may not have wings, but I can flap like a real paper.
Flap, flap, flap.
Hey,
flap, 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 flap. Squawk, squawk. Squawk, squawk. Squawk, squawk. Squawk, squawk,
Me
and also today is time I do Superman and his sidekicks.
Yeah, what's your view?
This is Scarlet McCaw.
Three
wings or rainbow
color
wings?
Rainbow wings.
Yeah, rainbow
definitely
wings.
Not the Decepticon wings.
Red yeah.
Does a Scarlet Macaw live in a tree or in a cave?
In a tree.
A cave? What? He doesn't live in Vince's cave, you idiot.
All his trees in the forest. Is a Scarlet Macaw afraid of a butterfly or a kawaii?
A kawaii.
What? A kawaii. Well, there's no way you're afraid of a butterfly. Unless it's wormy.
Yeah, wormy. Oh, that's, yeah, that. If it's afraid of wormy, then you better watch out. But, if it's another butterfly, I'm pretty sure it won't be afraid of Justin's girlfriend. Of course, Mario. All right. One more.
All
right.
Does Scarlet Macaw eat bananas or ice cream sundaes?
Bananas.
Bananas
because I want an ice cream sundae.
Yeah. Hey, that looks like the real life counterpart of Iago because Iago in the live action version of Aladdin, Iago looks just like that.
Wow! It got so! Oh! Hey! Hey! Okay. Hey, the fuck! I'm here to tell you with Tony and you go!
We sound the puzzle! This is Scarlet Macaw!
Alright, we print it out.
I think how they show what the animals are here, bro.
This picture of the Scarlet Macaw.
I know the animal science book. What about the animal science notebook?
Yeah. Hold on a second. Hello?
Hey, sweetie. I came up to bed and I forgot to play your website.
Oh. Good night. Good night.
I love you, sweetheart.
Love you, too. Mm-hmm.
All right, sweetie, I love you.
Love you, too.
All right, bye.
Bye. That was just my mom. Anyways.
We found out so much about Scarlet Macaws today, and there's so much more for us to discover.
Together.
Okay. Yeah, see you later, yo. Thank you for your bananas. Don't let you give up those shit.
Oh my god.
Oh wow. Okay. This is disrespecting your own time. How dare you? No, you. Oh my god. I'm not disrespecting my own kind, okay? I was just a little man in the bedroom because they weren't sharing. Right. They weren't sharing the bananas, they were eating for themselves!
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, guys, just be grateful that Woody and Boo just stopped them, okay? All right. Yeah, I mean, as they stopped, me and Super Bunny are cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is also the first time we've seen the credits to the show. Yep. And also in these pictures, they show clips of us from some previous episodes, including Three Little Condors, the episode we're watching right now, even Chinta the Baby Chinchilla.
Oh yes, you. I have noticed that.
Yep, and it stops right there. They didn't show the Nick Jr. Productions logo for some reason, but you know what? I'll play the logo because I'll go ahead and play the logo because why not? Okay. Lon?
I'll play this logo. Yeah. Okay. Anyways, guys, that's gonna be it for this episode of Let's Watch and Go Diego Go. We have two more episodes. We have two more shows we plan to watch tonight before we stop right there. Next episode, we're gonna be watching Wow Wow Wubsy, and then after that, if we have time, we're gonna watch the Upside Down show.
Oh yes, yes, yes! We're doing the Wubsy show now.
Yes, it's been a while since we haven't watched Wubsy show, but we're officially gonna be coming, making a comeback to it.
Oh, okay, yes, yes, yes. I will be sure to be there because, after all, Wubsy is my little buddy. Well, no, really, I'm not a widget, but I don't want to say it because you're a widget with sister, but I'm going to say this for once.
Yeah. Anyways, so yeah, we'll see you all in the next episode. That's what me and Boozy at the end of every video stream. Thanks so much for watching our stream. And I'll see you, and thanks so much for watching our stream. And we all hope you enjoyed. We'll see you in the next stream.
Yep, and what would you say? That's all, partners. Oh, yeah, bye. Yeah, bye, everyone. Bubba Bunny!